But none of this would be possible without the help of the amazing Fairfax PTA, the Fairfax teachers and staff, the Fairfax students, Heights High students, Heights High staff, and of course you, because we appreciate your generosity and support tonight with the cabaret. Specifically, I would like to thank Katrina Heinzen, Keith Newman, and Mrs. Tamara Gray for helping me through this process, making it easy, enjoyable, stress-free, and most importantly, fun. As you will see in your program tonight, we do not have a designated intermission. We ask that you feel free to get up, but please do it in between student performances. Eugene's will be running till 7:30, raffle baskets till 7:30, candy grams, and 50-50. So without further ado, let's sit back, relax, and watch our students shine. Thank you.
So remember, they really love big applause. So do that. Make sure your phones are turned off. Make sure you're ready to go. I mean, on silence, because I know you're taking pictures. But just let us enjoy the show and not too much talking. Really none when someone's performing. You guys, you're in for a treat. Enjoy the show.
Get in the room! I thought tonight. Sorry. I thought tonight would be virtual. Why are you wearing that? No, we've actually been out and haven't had a cabaret since January 2020, so we're excited to be back. It's great to see everybody, if you I can see. But we have a wonderful first act coming up. We have fifth grader Juniper Hare and her father, Mr. Brian Hare, that will be playing When the Saints Come Marching In on trumpet.
Thank you. students of Fairfax coming out to perform?
Fifth grader Jakiah Dillard will be performing a dance to Mutta. Here she is!
Thank you. I'm Bailey Burrow. I just got here. What did I miss?
A lot. Well, why don't you tell us who's up next?
Did you know that Fairfax has some student comedians?
I had no idea.
Well, get ready to laugh, because here come fifth grade jokesters, Francesca Merso and Olivia Drury.
Thank you.
grade solo, but the next act is a large group.
I know, and we're really good too.
Who are you?
I'm glad you asked. I'm Millie Rogoff, and I'm hosting the show. But I'm also in the next act. Gotta go!
Weird. Fairfax has lots of fun after school activities, and here's a performance by one of them. Please welcome the Obama Playwriters.
Just like yesterday. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Carrie Williams, and I am the education director at Obama Theater, located in the basement of the Lee Road Library. And this is the Young Playwrights Group at Fairfax Elementary. So, because we only have 3 minutes, we don't have time for everybody to read all the plays that they wrote this semester. So, just suffice to say that this group has been extremely creative with their instructor, James Rankin, writing about magic mushrooms, cats and hamsters, crayons, spaceships, water dragons, mysteries, murders, elevators, and SpongeBob. And we've learned a number of narrative elements, which you can see on the papers displayed before you. So, what we're going to do now, ladies and gentlemen, is a demonstration of specificity, which, if you've never heard before, is a word that means being specific, being very clear, being very obvious, because one of the ways that we tell stories is not only through writing, but also through our bodies and our faces. Go ahead and put your papers on the floor and spread out so you have plenty of room to make your statue. Yes, yes, yes. For this game, ladies and gentlemen, sometimes we play it for elimination, but today we're just going to demonstrate how it works. I'm going to give them a word, and then they're each going to make a statue of that word using their whole body and face and being as specific as possible. Ready?
Yeah.
First word is forest. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent. We have trees, we have creatures, we have, oh gracious me, all kinds of things. Now, is there anything you can do with your face or your body to make it even more obvious and specific? Yes, there we go. And erase it from your body back to neutral. Next word is surprise. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Surprises as far as the birthday kind and also the scary clown kind. Erase it from your body. Third word is animal. Now this one's a challenge because they each have to choose an animal to portray. Yes. And once again, particularly if you're a four-legged animal, how can you make it even more specific, even more clear? Act it out. Yes. And erase it. Now, in addition to playing for outs, sometimes they level up by doing statues that are not so much statues as they are moving tableaus, pictures that move. So, this time, this is the one where you find a partner or a group. Yes, yes, yes. So now we'll have several pictures with multiple bodies involved. The next word, there you go, is outer space. And this time, yes, we can have, oh, careful, careful. That was not part of rehearsal, but here we go. Excellent, and carefully erase it. And one more for a surprise. The next word, again, it's a moving one, so make sure you're careful and use your whole group. The next word is dream. And 5, 4, 3, 2, and close. Excellent. Erase it from the body. And I encourage you. cheer because it was really cool. Everyone grab your papers and let's go.
Millie was right. They were really good. I bet there are more fun after-school activities at Fairfax.
You're in luck, because the next act is another group of students who have fun and work hard at the school.
The dance club is taught by Miss Sloan, and they have an entertaining piece prepared. Let's give them a big round of applause, everyone.
Bye.
future stars. The next act is a star in the making, and also one of our after-school activities for Fairfax.
Under the direction of Mr. Chikatel, please welcome the Fairfax Drama Club.
And we're here to pump you up.
If you're not pumped up, if you're not pumped up already, then this act will definitely do the trick. Put your hands together for fourth grader Harper Petrie, who will sing Eye of the Tiger.
Yeah.
receiving class. The next act will be performed by another after-school activity group.
I know. I'm in this act too. Can you believe that I'm hosting the show and I'm in it too?
I'm smiling on the inside. Performing a spoken word piece, please welcome the Ink Spot.
This poem is called The Scare. In the dark, I see eyes. I hear a creak. I feel a claw. I think, what am I gonna do? I want to wake up. In the light, I see a parrot called squeak, a noise-making freak. I hear shrieks of little children. I feel horrified. I think, oh my God. I want to go home, and I wonder, where am I?
I'm going to be reading three haikus. Wolves howl at the moon, calling out to their packmates. So beautiful. My dog, Kibby, she is so loud, my eardrums. Ouch, I need some help. TV, I love you. So many cartoons to watch, let me watch another. Catlin by Olivia Earhart. Catlin is a magical place, formed of pink clouds with flowers like fireworks. 10 rainbow suns in a pitch black sky. The cat snooze all day and eat the food from the rainbow flowers. The leader of Catlin is Floofy's Maine Coon because he is a feline pom-pom. He has fur like Jupiter and sleeps 22/7. His job is to sleep longer than all the other cats. But the best part of Catlin is all of the extremely fluffy cats. If you come to this magical place, you'll be welcomed without any haste.
Good evening, reporting live from the city center. I'm so sorry, that's my other job. We're gonna take a quick time out in the proceedings to announce some of the raffle winners. Please get out your tickets, I will wait. I'm done waiting. The winner of the Parnell's Irish Pub basket is Sharon Sisko. The winner of the Aveda basket. Oh my God, my serum is from Aveda. Like, thank you, Under Eye Cream. Christy Nosul. Nosul. The winner of the Grog Shop, where I had a hideous open mic experience when I did stand up that one time, is Matt Bakaitis. The winner of the Guardians basket is S. Petrie. The winner of the Aquarium basket is Theo Leslie. And the winner of the Noble Beast number one is Mila Petrie.
Bear with me with names. Logan Berry is Hannah Vanna. The Max. Max Bax. Books. Bax. The same name.
Wow!
All right, for the play, we have Amelia Parks. Disney.
You're going to Disney.
Larissa McKinney. Brian's Marathon, Lillian Ganter, Mr. Brisket, Joy Park.
colleagues down. Thank you. Back to our previously scheduled programming. Bless you. Referring to the A spot thing. Wow, that was really cool. I feel like we should have snapped instead of applauded.
This is a story.
What story?
All about how my life got turned upside down. I'd like to take a minute just
should I sit right there?
And let me tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air.
Oh, yeah. If you're too young to understand that reference, we're going to throw back to some 90s hip-hop. Here comes the real thing. Please welcome, next on stage, our fifth graders Summer Jackson and Taylor Terry performing a dance to the iconic Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
This is Miss Factor performing How Far I'll Go and playing guitar.
As it
that shines on the sea, it's blinding, but no one knows how deep it goes. And it seems like it's calling out to me, so come find me and let me know what's beyond that line. Will I cross that line, see the line where the sky meets the sea? It calls me, and no one knows how far it goes. If the wind in my sail on the sea stays behind me, one day I'll know how far I'll go.
Yes, yes, we are back. I am here to mess up more names. All right, some more raffle winners. We have Splish Splash, Elliot Fleck, Arts and Crafts, Brian Hare, Cleveland Winery. Is it Janine? I think Janine Petrie? If I did the wrong thing. Jeannie!
We had a long discussion about Jeannie.
Jeanne,
Janine, Jenny.
It's my fault. It's definitely my fault. All right, we have Movie Night, Wesley Harris. Noble Beast 2, Nick Rosette.
Rosette?
We'll fix that, I promise. All right, we have Luna, Zabel, the Zabel family. Kevin Murphy Hare, we have Mrs. Klein.
Get that keratin treatment, queen. Heart of Glass Hair, oh, more hair. Robin Canyon. Heights Proud. Glacier.
Yay!
Yay! The Zoo. Chanel Houck. Sonos. Jen Parks. Tickets to a Cavs game, Mrs. Klein. Cleaning up over there. Zug, 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 Zug.
Zug.
I'm not from here, I'm sorry. Marcy P. Eugene's is the Zabel family. On the Rise, Oscar M. And now we will be back to our performance. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
tell you who they were and what they were gonna do. Lucas, hit it.
That was first grader Alex Jean playing the reading concerto in D minor on the violin with her brother. Third grader Spencer Jean.
That was awesome. I don't think my brothers would like to perform with me, unless the act was called Who Can Drive Me Crazy First.
That would be fairly entertaining.
The next act is another duet. Here come fifth grade dancing divas, Ayla Spicer and Akira Kerr.
Thank you.
Okay, she's gone, but she heard the applause. Thank you.
Thanks, Anna. I love talent shows. Don't you love watching me perform?
Sure. Now the audience is in for a real treat. Third grader Spencer Zong is back, but this time for a solo.
I think Spencer is one of those, what's it called? Oh, prodigies, like me. Please enjoy the Bach Prelude. Phew.
Gift cards. Katie Stricker. Luna Kate. Lori Billington. spirits, Mrs. Gray. Libations, the Booten family. Yoga, Brittany Dalton. Home, Richard Deals. And I think one of the best, Lucky Lotto, Nathan Parks. Oh, I do have one more. Now this nice drum right here, I was told the 50-50 raffle was over $1,000. They wouldn't tell me the exact amount, because they knew I would probably try to keep it. So I'm going to spin this twice and call a name. Ticket 1225.
Yay!
So, I have a very large fake check for you in the back, and if you need an escort, I will gladly help you. But we have one more wonderful act for you this evening. These are my friends, my co-workers. We do our best to service your children. So I hope you're ready for this. Our Fairfax staff dance. Please put your hands together.
Started years ago with community members and parents and myself. Over 25 years ago, every other year, we have come to have a cabaret. And I must tell you, I have worked with lots of parents and they have been wonderful. But this has been the most efficient one that I have worked, and I would say as long as I can remember. These parents have kept a tight ship. They have run it. We've come in with the show under time. Can we please give our PTA parents and teachers a big hand? It has been a pleasure. So for our last finale number, I'm gonna ask that if you were a performer, if you will come stand across the front of the stage, performers, as we sing our school song, Positive. Go ahead, Keith, you can start it. Stand across the front and we're singing it out the way we like to at school. Oh, they're coming on stage. Good enough. Okay, come on stage. I was trying to make it easy. Go ahead, Keith. Everybody in the audience who knows, please sing along. This is a song that we want to keep in our hearts forever. Let's clap. Every moment. So thank you so much. Good night, everyone. Please don't leave without your child. Good night. Have a good weekend.
When I keep it positive.
When I keep it positive.
I can close my eyes and picture.